online classes and I am your math teacher. And students, now we are going to solve math assignment number 15 of grade 5. Okay, beta, in this assignment we are going to start new chapter and the name of new chapter is ratio. Fine? Okay, beta, today I will tell you about the ratio, that what is the mean of ratio and how we can find the ratio of two or more quantity of the same kind. Okay, the topic name is ratio. Now open your book and turn out page number 101 and the chapter is 5. Chapter 5. Page number 101. Okay, beta, ratio. First I will tell you about the definition of ratio. Ratio is the comparison of two or more quantities of same kind. Understood, beta? Ratio is the comparison of two or more quantities of the same kind. And the symbol of ratio is this one. Fine? This is the symbol of ratio. Now, let's see this example. I will tell you that how we can find the ratio of two or more quantities. Okay, beta, let's suppose there are some markers, board markers, and some sharpeners. Fine? And they are asking about the ratio of board marker and sharpeners. So how we can find the ratio of board marker and sharpeners? So beta, first we will count the board markers. So how many board markers are here? 1, 2, 3. So there are 3 board markers. Fine? Now put the ratio sign symbol and now count the sharpeners. There are how many sharpeners? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6. It means the ratio of board marker to sharpener is 3:6. And if we represent as ratio of board marker board markers 2 mean ratio 2 sharpness. Fine? The ratio of board markers 2 means we will put the symbol of ratio 2, put the symbol of ratio and then sharpness, number of sharpener. So the ratio of board marker to sharpener is 3:6. Fine? Understood, beta? Okay. Now in the ratio of 3:6 can be represent into fraction form. Okay, beta, the ratio of board marker to sharpener 3:6 can be represent or can be write in fraction form. 3/6. So it's clear that there is a close relationship between fraction and ratio. Ratio can be converted into the fraction form and fraction form also can be write into the ratio form. Fine? Understood, beta? And in the ratio of 3 and 6, here the 3 is called the first term. And 6 is called the second term. Fine? done in the ratio 3 ratio 6. Find the first term, means this one, the first term in the ratio of 3 ratio 6 is 3. Why? Because the board markers are mentioned first, that one. Fine? That's why 3 is the first term. And the ratio of sharpener to board marker. Sharpener to board marker, then we will write 6 ratio 3. When they are asking about the ratio of sharpeners to ratio of to board markers. So in this statement, the sharpener has come first. That's why we will write the number of sharpener first, and then 2 mean put the ratio symbol. Then write on board markers how many board markers we have? 3. So 6 ratio 3. Understood, Peter? So remember that 3 ratio 6 and 6 ratio 3 are not the same ratio as 3 ratio 6 is 3 by 6 and 6 ratio 3 is 6 by 3. So that's why these two ratios are not same ratio. Fine, beta? Okay. Now 3 ratio 6. 3 ratio 6. Fine? Okay. Now come on the second topic. Okay, now second topic is equivalent ratio. Fine? Okay, beta. Equivalent ratio means that let's suppose there are 21 bananas and 18 apples. And they are saying that find out the equivalent ratio of 21 banana to 18 apples. So how we can write 21 banana and 18 apple in the ratio form? As let the statement is 20 represent the ratio of banana to apple. So first the banana word has come. Its mean we will write the number of banana first, 21 to 18 apples. Now we can simplify. We can find the simplest form of 21 and 18. So look at it, beta. 21 has come in the table of 3 and 18 has also come in the table of 3. Fine. So when we will divide 21 by 3, so what will be the answer? 3 sevens are 21. And when we will divide 18 by 3, so what will be the answer? 3 sixes are 18. And 7 and 6 cannot further divide by the same table. So it's mean 21 and 18 are the equivalent ratio of 7 and 6. So we can write 7 ratio 6 equivalent means equal. We will write equal sign. Equivalent ratio of 21 ratio 18. Understood, beta? Okay. Now watch this video.
Mom, I'm thirsty. Please make a glass of orange drink for me. Okay, Vinay. Wait, Mom. I want to see how to make it so that I'll be able to make it for my friends when they come in the evening. Mom, how did you know what to add and how much?
It is written on the bottle. To make a glass of drink, take 1 cup of orange squash. Pour it into a glass, add 3 cups of water to it, and then mix them well. Your drink will be ready to serve.
Mummy, please make 1 drink for me too.
Now, how will you add the squash and water to make the drinks for both of us?
See, to make it for one person, we have to take 1 cup of squash and 3 cups of water. For 2 persons, we have to double the quantities of both the squash and water. That means we need to take 2 cups of squash and 6 cups of water. Think, if I have to make it for 3, then we have to take 3 cups of squash and 9 cups of water.
Here, the quantity of water we have added is 3 times the quantity of squash. How did you find it out? If we divide the number of cups of water by the number of cups of squash, we get 3 each time. Mummy, it is denoting 3 times 1.
Correct. You know, here you are comparing using ratios.
What is a ratio?
The comparison of 2 quantities in terms of how many times is called ratio. Here, the ratio of squash to water is 1:3, and it is read as 1:3. Using ratio, it is easy to calculate.
How?
The ratio of squash to water for 1 person is 1:3. If we have to make it for 2 persons, then multiply the ratio by 2. Then it becomes 2:6. For 3 persons, multiply it by 3. That is 3:9. Can you find how much squash and water is to be added for 10 persons?
For 10 persons, I have to take 10 cups of squash and 30 cups of water. And I come to know by multiplying the ratio by 10.
Here, for all the ratios we have found, we have added water 3 times of squash. That means the ratio is constant here. Such ratios, which are obtained by multiplying or dividing by any counting number, are equivalent ratios.
1:3 is its lowest form, as it can't be further divided.
Correct. Now you get it. We have used the squash and water in the ratio of 1:3. For this, can you write the ratio of water to 1 glass of drink made?
I think it is 3:1.
No, Vinay, we can't calculate ratio in different units. Here, the unit for water is 3 cups. Then we have to use the same unit for the drink also.
1 glass of drink contains 1 cup of squash and 3 cups of water. That is, 4 cups are poured into 1 glass to make 1 drink.
Yes, that is why the ratio of quantity of water to drink is 3:4.
And for quantity of squash to drink, it becomes 1:4. So, while writing ratios, first we have to convert different quantities in the same unit.
Okay, beta, I guess you have understood. No. Come on, Dham. Practice questions. Okay, beta, complete this book work with pencil on book. And now, turn out page 112. 112, practice question. Fine? Now, question number 3. And the first part is They are saying they are find out the missing number. Fine? Missing number. So the first part is 2:5 equal. It means they are asking about the missing part in the equivalent ratio. Desh ratio 10. So the 5 has become 10. So it means when we will multiply 5 with 2, will become 10. It means 2 will also will multiply with 2. 2 to the 4. And the missing number is 4. Understood, Beto? 3 part D. Part D is 3:12:18:1 equal to 1 into, there are 2 numbers are missing. So how we can find? So 3, the first number is 3 and here is the 1. It means when we will divide 3 by 3, the word will obtain. So 3 will divide also 3 by 3, 1 is answer. So 3 will also divide by 12 and 18. So 3 4s are 12 and 3 6s are 18. So it means there are 4 and 16 missing numbers. 4 and 6. There are 2 missing numbers that are 4 and 6. And distributor, no rest 2 parts are your task. Question number 4. Question 4 is, express each of the following ratio into the simplest form. It means they are asking about the simplest form. Now how we can find the simplest form? Part C, 6:18:8 is equal to ... Now how we can find the simplest form? Okay, 6, 18 and 8. All the numbers can be divided by the table of 2. So first we will divide by the table of 2. 6 divided by 2, 18 divided by 2, ratio 8 divided by 2. So what will be the answer? 2 3s are 6, ratio 2 9s are 18, 2 4s are 8. No, these numbers cannot be divided further by the same table. So we will stop here. It means these are the simplest terms of 6, 18 and 8. So the first one is 3, then ratio. The second one is 9 and the ratio of 4. These are the 3 terms. 3, 9 and 4. Understood better? Okay, now do the practice of rest all the parts in your notebook. Sorry, in your book. Fine? Okay, now. Okay, sorry. Okay, beta. Now rest all the parts are your task. Complete this one. Fine? Complete these all the parts. Okay. Okay, thank you.